Hey guys, Dr. Huntington here. So in this video, I'm going to cover the mineral iron and how it impacts the health of your brain. As you probably know, having a sufficient amount of iron is critical for mental function, but too much iron can cause just the opposite effect and lead to accelerated aging and cognitive disease. So you want to make sure that you get enough, but not too much. And that's why you'll sometimes hear of iron referred to as the Goldilocks mineral. All right, so probably the best known role of iron in your body is its role in supplying energy to your cells. And it does this by helping your blood deliver oxygen. You see, iron is needed by your body to make hemoglobin, which helps red blood cells carry oxygen to your brain. In fact, 2/3 of the iron in your body is found in your red blood cells. And so if you lack iron, you won't be able to make enough hemoglobin. And a lack of hemoglobin can result in symptoms like shortness of breath, a rapid heartbeat, dizziness, chest pain, swelling in your hands or feet, pale skin and fatigue, including mental fatigue or just like dull mental performance. Even a mild deficiency can impact memory and learning and attention span. Iron is concentrated in varying amounts in different regions and cells of your brain. It's involved in oxidative metabolism, which is the process where oxygen is used to make energy from carbohydrates. Iron is also involved in the function of neurotransmitters, and is super critical for the building and maintenance of myelin, which is the protective coating around your nerves. And what myelin does is it allows nerve cells to communicate efficiently. In fact, iron is especially critical for babies in utero, infants, and children, because the deficiency during those periods can cause irreversible cognitive damage, affecting behavior and learning. In fact, having enough iron during early childhood will help dictate brain health in adulthood. Even subtle variations in iron levels matter. Studies have shown a correlation between poor math and language tests and low iron levels in children. Even ADHD has been improved in some children with iron supplementation. The reason it's so important is that getting sufficient iron during childhood and adolescence creates better myelin integrity. Remember, that's the coating around the nerves and sets the foundation for strong cognitive skills as an adult. Adults will also experience neurological changes without enough iron. And this can show up as fatigue and brain fog, restless leg syndrome and depression and anxiety. Now, on the other hand, too much iron can be toxic, especially in the brain. And as a component of hemoglobin, iron helps carry oxygen. But when iron isn't bound to another molecule, excess iron can accelerate free radical production in your body, increasing oxidative stress, overall aging, and risk for disease. And in terms of the relationship between the brain and oxidative stress, an overload of oxidative stress in the brain has been linked to cell death and degenerative brain disorders such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. Excess iron in your body, it gets stored in your liver. And the problem here is that it could lead to cirrhosis, which is, where your liver becomes scarred and tough. Excess iron can also cause joint and hormonal problems and increase your risk for diabetes. Now, where the risk of iron overload is highest is in those with a hereditary disease called hemochromatosis, as well as people who are in advanced age. And the reason for that is iron levels tend to increase as you get older. The other place where iron toxicity tends to be a problem is in men who supplement with too much iron. Now, in the case of having too much iron, donating blood is the easiest way to lower your iron level. And this is why women are less at risk than men in terms of having too much iron, because of their menstrual cycle. Now, in terms of iron deficiency, it can be caused by low dietary intake, a lack of absorption due to digestive disorders, or heavy blood loss. Also, certain medications can cause an iron deficiency. And also consuming, of course, too much calcium because calcium can actually interfere with iron absorption, like if you have too much of it. Now, in terms of getting enough iron in your diet, some good sources would include things like red meat, liver, and other organ meats, turkey and shellfish, such as clams and mussels and oysters. They're all good sources, but some others include spinach and broccoli, as well as pumpkin seeds. And if you know your level of iron is low, you can also use a supplement to help as well. Concentrated iron supplements are usually needed among pregnant women, regular blood donors, dialysis patients, or people who are on a medication that depletes their iron levels. Now, if you're not in one of those categories, make sure that you know that your iron level is low before you take an iron supplement. Because remember, you don't want to have too little, but you don't want to have too much. All right, so I hope that helps. And if you've enjoyed this video, please share it with a friend. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel. All right, I'll see you in the next one.